Good morning. Hey, this morning I wanted to talk a little bit about racial healing. So justice is good and justice is necessary. And God is a just God and He wants justice for all. But justice and healing are two different things. They're both necessary. So let's just say if a crime was committed against me and that person received justice, and they went to prison, that's a good thing. But I would still need the healing for what took place against me. Justice is good and so is healing. Both are necessary for racial reconciliation. And I don't think power and payback is what this country needs. The rioting and looting and burning and destruction might be cathartic, but it's not going to bring healing. And let's just say that for the racial inequality that's happening right now, let's just say even if we did replace everyone in office with African Americans, or there are reparations made to African Americans, that still wouldn't bring the healing that needs to take place inside someone's heart in order for reconciliation to take place. Justice and healing are separate. So I think some of you know that I was abused as a little girl. I was sexually abused by a relative. And I had to go through a lot of therapy and a lot of EMDR and dealing with trauma to get free from that. And it was a very painful process. And I want to submit to you that there is trauma and that there is PTSD in our African American brothers and sisters. Not only what has been done to them and what they've personally experienced, but there's also secondary trauma from the hearing of all the stories passed down through the generations, which has solidified their beliefs about who they are right now in our country. When someone says to you, Black Lives Matter, how do you respond? And now I'm not talking about the organization. I am not pro Black Lives Matter, the organization. But when someone says to you, Black Lives Matters, how do you respond? Do you immediately respond with, oh, well, all lives matter? When someone says Black Lives Matter, you have to look behind that. If someone said to me, if I told somebody I was sexually abused as a very little girl, and someone said to me, well, a lot of little girls were sexually abused. What needs to happen when I tell someone I was sexually abused as a little girl, someone needs to respond, oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. Because you have to hear the heart behind the words that are being said. And so now when I hear Black Lives Matter, you know what my response is? They do. And if someone says to you, one of our African American friends says to you about slavery and the things that were endured many years ago, and you say, well, that was a long time ago. Well, I have to tell you that if I told someone I was sexually abused as a very little girl, and I'm 51 now, and someone said, that was a long time ago. You know what? Our past impacts us. And so I, for my own process, had to go through, I had to find a place where I could grieve. There were a lot of tears. And I could heal, and I could forgive, and I could let God's love in to bring healing. And I want to submit to you that in order for healing to take place in the African American community, that we need to create a place for grief and for forgiveness, for listening, for repentance. So that's all I want to say today about that. And I know maybe that's offended some of you, but can we just pray? So God, I pray that you would change our hearts, that we would see people not through our own eyes, not through our own paradigm, but we would see people through your eyes. John 3:16 said, for God so loved the world. It's all people of all colors. And God, what I know is that you're a just God, that you're a God of love and mercy and healing, and only you can bring the justice and the racial reconciliation that our country so desperately needs. God, I pray that you would fill our hearts with humility and with compassion for this process, and that we would participate. This is not going to be a sprint. This is a marathon of bringing healing into our country, and only you can do it, God. We pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, you guys, hope you have a good day.